the freezing marks. Everything's all slushy and wet. And really windy. Snow later today, but no snow out there right now. First thing in the morning. Welcome to the edition of Headbanging CD Case Big Weather Production. A little bit of Nazareth. Oh, you want to see how much snow? Well, it may not look that impressive, but cloudy. Hey, cloudy, it's cloudy out. Rainy time, it's crane time. I don't know if there's if that's a jet engine or a bullet or anyway. Plus two anyway, at least enough as a low zero.
Well, to pay for his music collection, Greg the Egg takes to driving a bus in the Great White North. Rock Hall with Greg the Egg, Blackmore Rose here. Yeah, Kiss Live in Las Vegas 2014. Bought this a while ago, but I shelved it. I haven't heard this for, I might have heard it just once through, but got reminded of it, so I thought I better listen to some. Look at that bus, that's fantastic. Best bus I've ever seen, probably. As for a set list, I would say 7 out of the 13 songs, I would have no problem putting them in a Kiss set list. Then it goes just a little lower standard to me, for my taste anyway. I like the early Kiss, so that's the issue. Good booklet though. Look at this picture. That'd be a great t-shirt. So this is the version with the CD and the DVD of the concert, which I haven't watched yet, but darn, I'd better, especially after looking at these pictures. I don't know, I still think the Kiss is the best concert I ever saw. Just tough to say, because I've seen Deep Purple and Black Sabbath and Judas Priest and Iron Maiden. But look at that. Just wish I could have seen him back in the day. But I've seen him twice. Actually, I've seen a few Kiss tribute bands, and man, they're great to watch too, actually. Lots of guitar picks to throw to the crowd. But I had a nice hoodie that was this on both sides, but when I saw Kiss tribute band, I thought, oh heck, so I gave it to the drummer just as a thank you for practicing and whatever else they go through. Anyway, let's get on with the action. Very curious about this. I saw LA Guns back in about 2004 type deal. I don't know what year this concert, I haven't heard this yet, so print's so small. 2021. Okay, wow. It's So the sound should hopefully be really good. Not too polished. But yeah, they're fun live. I really don't know much about them because I don't listen to their studio stuff for some stupid reason, but... anyway, gotta move on. Probably show these guys in a... punk rock update. I don't know. It depends what they sound like, though, but... I know they do one song that I really love. So I don't know, the Bouncing Souls. Yeah, I can't talk about them much because I just... but they're just a couple of bucks each, so... I'll feature them another day, maybe. This is kind of a water-damaged one, so it was really cheap, but the booklet's all stuck together, so there's no way of getting it to read it, but it's got the... again, you can't read it. It's two different mixes anyway. Different order here, but two different mixes of the album, so that'll be interesting. I always thought that's a pretty cool album cover. There's one of the best emblems in rock history. I know that Michael Schenker group. I love that. My brother made a jacket of that back in about 1980 or 81. Silk screened it. I bugged him a few times. So, do you mind? Do you think you would sell it to me? Or nope. So I don't blame him. And this is interesting. Status Quo. They had the big Frantic Four reunion tour, 2013. Where all the original guys from the Classic Quo era got together. And I saw them on this tour. And they were great live, I loved it. I was really late to the show with Status Quo, but I like them live the best for sure. And this is from, yeah, the Hammersmith Apollo. I love it, when they ever say Hammersmith Odeon, Hammersmith Apollo, it just sounds so otherworldly. Like, I would never get to go to that kind of venue, but man, it must have been unbelievable. Saw them outdoors on a nice summer day outdoor festival. It's the only band I went for and stayed for. Luckily it wasn't very pricey, but it was worth it. But their first live album is one of the heaviest, boogiest albums you'll ever hear. Just raw and heavy. But here's another live album from them, Frantic Four's Final Fling. Live at the Dublin O2 Arena. So it's their very final show together. I think it was a year after that original one. Yeah, I think everyone should have one Status Quo early live album, or even these later ones. The reunion is just... it's heavy enough. Like, it's just rock and boogie once they start sweating. I'll probably show this on a punk rock hat trick. Canadian punk rock. But yeah, they're really fun, really Ramones inspired. Nuclear Strike Zone. A lot of the songs are about baseball. But anyway, I'll show that another day. Here's Ritchie Blackmore. I just thumbed through this just to see if I'd like or to want to say any of these. Iggy Pop said, I think I'm lucky enough that I didn't get paid enough to drown in the syrup of its success. And I had some other one dog-eared. Oh, Ritchie Blackmore I like leaping around on stage as long as it's done with class. And, oh, Billy Joel. Typical day in the life of a heavy metal musician consists of a round of golf and an AA meeting. So anyways, pretty funny, lots of goofball quotes, 8-track action. Don't see many Jimi Hendrix 8-tracks around. And Nazareth. This album sold tons in Canada. I wonder if it's their best-selling album in Canada. And Canada was Nazareth's biggest-selling country in the world. Yeah, Program 3, Program 4. Good, Razmanaz opened it up too. Perfect. Great album. That'd be a great shirt as well. Oh, I didn't think I was going to go this long. Anyway, Stones on 8-track. And Alice Cooper, Greatest Hits. And the only song I ever liked on this album was Tie Your Mother Down, which is 10 out of 10. I think it's the third song on the thing. It should have opened. And actually, it does the fade out where it goes from program 1 to 2, fades out, then click, then it starts in on the song, if you remember that from 8 tracks. And shirt action. This more a traitor, because I'm not into this band at all. And I remember when this album came out, I thumbed through it and I didn't like it one bit. It's just not my taste, whatever. Not everyone can like the exact same stuff all the time, so otherwise it'd only be one band, but cool shirt. And this guitarist, Slash, I saw when I saw Ozzy and Friends. Oh, there's nothing on the back. He had 3 guest guitarists, Gus G, Slash, and he had Zach Wilde, all his guest guitarists. And my favorite one was Gus G because he sounded the most like Randy Rhoads. But anyway, you don't see many Black Label Society shirts. Anyway, that does it for the big show, so thanks for watching. And don't forget, slower traffic, keep left and right, Rick Cloudy. AC/DC rules.